Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Angela Brennan and today I'm bringing you the Spellbinder Stitched for Christmas collection. You know how I love stitching dies, so I still got many more ideas but I didn't want to have the video too long, though it is one of my longer videos, just over 30 minutes. I will certainly be doing another video showcasing how I can use these dies in different ways. But for now, there's four sets of dies. The first one is about sweaters and various elements that you can put on sweaters. There's one on trees, and there's one on holly and poinsettia. And finally, the one with the starry argyle background. That's one of my favorites because you can do so many color combinations with that, but I stopped at five. But there's different ways you can use it. It's such a fun set, versatile, and of course, stitching excites me anyhow. The video is quite self-explanatory, and I've got a lot more information in my blog, so do head over to my blog. The link to my blog is in the description below, along with all the products that I've used in the video. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and do consider subscribing. And when you do subscribe, remember to press that notification bell so you're alerted when a new video is uploaded. I'm going to leave you with some music now and I'll catch you later. I used a background that is called strips of card stuck together, that's my background, and rather than use the outline to cut the tree, I just used the stitch dots, so I will do the sewing directly onto the striped background. You don't always have to cut it out, so I'm trying something different here, and I use silver thread. I use all six strands of the silver thread to do this. You'll see the card at the end.
Thank you.
Here are the completed cards, all 11 of them. I loved using the Starry Argyle background because you can do many color combinations, and I used a variety of colors in it. Most of it I used four colors for two similar shades and a couple of similar shades basically. Like this one, you've got two reds, two greens, and I think it looks nice. And I used three strands for most of it. Here I use the metallic threads, so I use a single strand, which is easier to do. Metallic threads are not the easiest to sew, single strand is easier to manage. And I use different colors. Here I use some light blues and some various shades of green. And this one, I just use two colors, but I use six strands, so it looks thicker. So on the left one, you can see I've used metallic threads, which is single strand, and the red background, I use six strands. The blue background, three strands. So you can see a slight variation in how the Argyle background comes about. I enjoyed this background very much. This is the stitched Christmas tree die where I did some stitching. I used the stitched Christmas tree die in the Argyle background as well, but I didn't do stitching in that. So you can use this Christmas trees with or without stitching. And here is where I did the stitching directly onto the striped background, and I used a six strand metallic silver. Not the easiest to sew, but I like the effect. Here I kept the Christmas tree very simple by just using the outline without any stitching, but I did some embossing, some clear embossing after doing some ink blending. I loved how this turned out. So you can use the stitched elements of the dies or not. And this is the Christmas sweater stitch die set. I enjoyed using this. You can actually also stitch on the sweater, and I did not show that here. I'll do that in my next video when I use these dies again. It's so versatile. You can use it in many, many ways. You can use the snowflake, the bauble, as well as the little Christmas tree separately on a card without the sweater as well. So there are so many other ways to use these cards, and I shall be using them in my next video in the coming months. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and do consider subscribing. And when you do subscribe, remember to press that notification bell so you're alerted when a new video is uploaded. Happy crafting, and I'll catch you later.